McCarran doesn't like it when civilians wander into military outposts, so if you're here on business, better make it quick. Ranger Station Charlie, we're responsible for keeping the highway up through Novac civilized. All quiet at the moment. Ranger Beaumont is in charge here, but he's off leading a patrol. Radio signal out here can be pretty spotty because of all the hills. Sometimes our scheduled updates don't go through. When it happens enough times, they send someone over to check up on us. Lately, we've been getting extra medical supplies for some reason. I'm in no rush to give the supplies back, either. I shouldn't have said anything in the first place. I'd rather not get you into the habit of crossing the NCR. Part scout, part commando, part sheriff. The training is brutal, and I'd say 8 out of 10 recruits washes out before the end. Before you get your Ranger badge, you've got to prove you can be quieter than a shadow and more ferocious than a Deathclaw. Couple dozen, I'd say. Most of them posted at stations like this one. We either man the station or patrol the immediate area. The Rangers mostly draw from the basic NCR Army. A trooper who shows exceptional skill at fighting and scouting can be nominated for the training. Sure. See you around. Thank you.
Well, Butter My Button call me a biscuit if it ain't my old friend from Good Springs. Don't rightly know. I just got the notion to make my way to New Vegas. Reckon I'll find out when I get there. No, don't believe I did. But you might ask around. The Novac folk usually see anyone traveling this way. Likewise, friend, likewise. Is there anything old Vic can do you for? Well, this ain't New Vegas, but I reckon you can find what you need here. Try the office out front. Be seeing you.
Damn it. Don't sneak up on me like that. What do you want? Yeah, I guess maybe I am. But not like you. Huh. Maybe it should have been you I was expecting all along. Why are you here? Yeah, well, you see anybody wearing Legion Crimson or a lot of sports equipment, you just let me know. You still haven't answered my question. There's nothing up here. I think you better leave. Wait. You just got into town. Maybe you shouldn't go. Not just yet. I need someone I can trust. You're a stranger. That's a start. I want you to find something out for me. I don't know if there's anything to find, but I need someone to try. My wife was taken from our home by Legion slavers one night while I was on watch. They knew when to come and what route to take, and they only took Carla. Someone set it up. I don't know who. My wife's dead. I want the son of a bitch who sold her. I know, all right. That's all you need to know. I said it was a start. This town, nobody looks me straight in the eye anymore. Bring him out in front of the nest here while I'm on duty. I work nights. I'll give you my NCR beret to put on. It'll be our signal, so I know you're standing with him. And I'll take care of the rest. I need to do this myself. Good. I'll make it worth your while. And one more thing. We shouldn't speak again. Not until it's over. No one in town knows that I know what happened to my wife. Best they never know. Or the Legion will be after me next. Yeah. What's going on, man? Yeah, see ya.
Hey there. If you want to buy something from a shop, you'll have to wait till it opens. Sure, but he didn't buy any souvenirs, if that's what you're wondering. Sounded like he didn't have his money with him. His friends seemed disappointed about it. Heck, I would be too if I found such a fine store and left my money elsewhere. Manny might know more about him. Thought he might have been friends with one or two of them. He's up in the dino mouth during the day. Can't say we spoke much. Boom did most of the buying for him. She was in the store once, but she didn't stay long. Had a look on her face like she'd smelled something sour. But far as I can remember, the gift shop smelled fine. Well, fine as it always does. Come back soon now.
Hey. We haven't met yet. You must be new in town. I'm Andy. Carla was a knockout. Whenever Boone walked around with her, he always had this funny grin on his face like he couldn't believe his luck. I know we couldn't. That wasn't the only reason she stuck out, though. That girl never minced words. If she'd had better food or hospitality, she'd let you hear it. Trouble was, she usually had. I don't think she meant it. She really was a sweet girl. I think she just wanted to remind herself that there's still nicer places in this world than Novac. Who could blame her for that? Was with them. That was back when my arm and leg used to work better. I still like to pretend I'm a ranger, though. I'll check in with the guys up at the station pretty regular on the ham radio. Sometimes they stop by, tell me they're paying their respects, the smug bastards. They haven't been responding to me last couple days. I guess they got tired of hearing me talk, but it still got me a little worried. Hell, listen to me talk, like some damn mother hen. Like what? Look out for yourself.
What's going on, man? Sure, I know him. What do you want with him? Must be something pretty important to be chasing a guy like that. Well, listen, I can definitely help you find him, but I've got problems of my own. Maybe we can do a trade. You need my help. There's something I need, too. Novac? It's home for me now. I want that to be for good. I like it here, and I've left too many homes behind. But the only resource we got here is junk. Without that, people wouldn't have anything to trade. They'd all have to leave. We get most of it up the road from the old rocket test site, but a bunch of ghouls showed up one day and took it over. We can't get in there now. I would, but I've got to watch the road. Caesar's Legion has been taking territory just east of here. They took Nelson. If we let our guard down, they might attack. All it takes for the Legion is for them to sense weakness. Well, they gotta go, or this'll be a ghost town before long. Doesn't matter to me what you do. As long as the ghouls are out of there, that's good enough for me. It'd mean a lot to me. Yeah, see ya.
Hey there. Is everything all right? Awful late to be dropping in unexpected. How should I put it? I guess you could say she was kinda like a cactus flower. Real pretty to look at, but there was just no getting close to her. She never did take to living here. She liked the big lights and fast living of New Vegas. I got the feeling she was trying to get Boone to leave with her, but I guess she got tired of waiting. Watch out for strangers!
Hey there. In from out of town, ain't you? Name's Dusty. Well, to be honest with you, I don't really know them two as well as I might. I remember she had an edge about her, like she'd rather be someplace else. This kind of life ain't for everyone, that's for darn sure. Oh, I tend to my ranch, that's about it. Alice'll tell you, I don't get out a whole lot. You must mean what's left of it. Somebody's been attacking our animals at night. We're down to less than half of what we had a few weeks back. So long.
What brings you here?
Boone. That's that sniper fellow. Works in the dinosaur, right? I only met them but once or twice. They seem real happy together. I really ought to get to know them better. They're probably nice folk. Nice of you to visit.
Between you and me, I don't think she studied at an accredited institution.
What can I do for you? Later.
She hasn't paid me anything yet. Should I be worried?
Howdy. Fine weather for flying. It's times like these that make me miss it all. Four? No, not exactly. It was a long time ago. Things are a lot different these days, and those days are way behind me. Vertibird pilot. 71 missions and only lost one chopper. Rotor malfunction over Klamath. Hard landing, but I walked away. I help folks strip down the more complicated bits of salvage they bring in. Engines, mostly. The bits and pieces we take out are usually worth more than the whole thing put together. Watch your six out there.
You have any luck with the ghouls? Yeah, see ya.
Hey there.
What brings you here?
It's kind of late, but I guess if it's important to you.
That's it, then. How did you know? You didn't have any proof? God damn it, this wasn't supposed to be a guess. She might not have done a goddamn thing. Get out. I don't ever want to see you again. You stay the hell away from me.
Over here. Are you listening? Go to the big room on the east side of this building and take the metal staircase all the way up. And hurry. Who I am doesn't matter, Smooth Skin. Stop wasting time and get up here. Like I said, find the metal staircase in the big room on the east side of the building. It's where they used to make rockets. Get moving.
Thank you.
right, Smoothskin. I'm letting you in. You better watch yourself. I'll sure as hell be watching you.
God, but are you ugly? Get upstairs and talk to Jason before I throw up just from looking at you. Your pranks won't work on me, Smoothskin. They won't work on Jason either. Stop wasting my time, Smoothskin. Go waste Jason's.
Morning.
Hello, Wanderer. Please forgive us our humble surroundings. Our true home awaits us in the far beyond. Have you come to help us complete the great journey? You're referring to Chris. I doubt you had much luck if you tried telling him that he's human. We had the same discussions when he first appeared, and the same lack of success. He believes he is one of us. Soon enough, we realized that Chris was a gift from the Creator. He is integral to the success of the Great Journey. We wish to escape the barbarity of the Wasteland, especially the violence and bigotry of its human inhabitants. The Creator promised to my flock a new land, a place of safety and healing, a paradise in the far beyond. Preparations for the Great Journey were nearly complete when the demons appeared. The demons appeared from nowhere, except it might be more accurate to say they never actually appeared at all. The demons are invisible. Where one of them stands, the most one sees is the air shimmering like sunlight on water. They set upon us as we were on our way to worship one morning. We had just entered the basement. My flock fought bravely and killed a few, but at such cost. Nearly half of us died or went missing. The rest of us retreated up here. One of the demons raved at us, but they have not tried to attack us since. Still, their demonic presence brought all progress towards the Great Journey to a standstill. But now you have come. Once again, the Creator has sent a human to help us across a seemingly insurmountable obstacle. I am Jason Bright, the prophet of the Great Journey. All the ghouls you see here are members of my flock. An auspicious name, don't you think? It was mine before I became as I am now, before the Great War even. Truly does the Creator author a destiny for each and every one of us. The means by which the Great Journey is to be accomplished are an article of faith, not to be discussed with outsiders. I have glimpsed it only in visions, Wanderer, but what I have seen is truly miraculous. It is a place of light and healing, and I know in my soul that my flock will be safe there. Yes, over the intercom. Threats of death should we step outside. Guarantees of safety should we stay locked away. It went on for hours and did not always make sense. But that was the first day only. Since then, silence. Will you drive away the demons, Wanderer? But we have no hope of completing the Great Journey without your help. Will you help us, Wanderer? Yes, Wanderer?
Thank you.
here!
Who sent you? I ain't talk. I give up. Folks will tell you that they seen ghoul. Sensation. Let me know if you meet anyone
have any luck with the ghouls? I'm counting on you.
Really? Unbelievable, man.
I knew that wasn't gonna be easy. But I had a good feeling about you. You look like... Okay, I'll tell you everything I know, like I promised. The guy you're looking for, Benny, he was traveling with some members from my old gang. They were going to Boulder City. It's straight up Route 93 from here. Just keep following the road north. No clue. I know Benny hadn't paid up yet. Maybe that was where they were supposed to get square. Hope that helps. I owed you. I'm Manny. I'm on security detail here. You see a rifle barrel sticking out of the dinosaur's mouth, you got a 50-50 shot it's me. Otherwise, it's Boone. I'm Manny. Yeah, see ya.
Hey there.